could breaking the law be the only way to make a difference?
Well, after being arrested for her role in the protest yesterday, lawyer Farhana Yamin joins us to explain why she thinks radical action is the only way forward.
And alongside her is broadcaster Nick Ferrari, who has labelled the protests ridiculous. Welcome to you both.
Welcome. Good morning.
Farhana, you this morning you actually were released from Lewisham Police Station. Now, right off the bat, is it appropriate, do you think, to break the law in order to get the point across?
I do. That's why I was in the police cell yesterday and alongside hundreds of others who have committed to doing that. Mm-hmm. I'm really sad that we've got to this point in time where after 30 years of, you know, negotiations, 30 years of scientists warning us, Rochelle, that, you know, we can expect to see in the UK droughts mm-hmm. as well as mm-hmm. floods. You know, we're at that point where we haven't done enough. So this is why I did what I did yesterday, right. but as much part of a much bigger civil disobedience movement.
Is the right way to make people listen? Do you think people are listening to you in the right way, or do you think people are taking it as, you know, there's
frustration.
Yeah, they're frustrated because of what's happening in London. Do you think it's the right attention you want?
I think people need to know that we've been doing three decades, 30 years, you know, I've gone grey doing this. 30 years we've been trying to educate the public, educate the politicians, ask for the right action to take place.
Yeah.
And this is, you know, the final call, really, for us to wake up and show some leadership. And people have often, you know, heard about the information. But if I can be candid, they've taken a little bit of the attitude that you had to Dave's report about the flooding, about the threat the UK faces to droughts. People are warning us. It's not that he's cuckoo. He's completely right. The UK Met Office has warned that we are expecting droughts to increase in severity. This isn't about a little bit of sunshine at Easter. This is really, really important. So British farmers have been affected last year, both by droughts and also by floods. So that we're going to get the wrong type of rain
just
at the
to
wrong
clear up,
time.
I have no attitude with the fact that we're facing a drought.
It's about the seriousness of the actual long-term thing. This isn't about the weather day to day. This is about the longer-term patterns and the devastating impacts that they can have on water and food security.
Nick, I can see you're sitting, shaking your head. Mm-hmm. I'll give you the same question and then you can go ahead.
Sure.
Do you think it's appropriate to break the law in order to get the point across?
To your central point, yes. Mm-hmm. We wouldn't have emancipation. We wouldn't have a lot of very necessary changes unless very brave people had, in some instances, broken the law. Uh-huh. Coming to what we see today, Farhana, I understand you're a lawyer, so you'll know about human rights, right? What about the human rights of people who want to get to work across a bridge in London, who want to go to a hospital? You'll be aware that there's a very major hospital in London on the south side, who are sick, who need to visit relatives, and they are denied. Why are their human rights suddenly not worth yours for their lives or their livelihoods? How come you trump that? What does it say about climate change that I appreciate you weren't involved in this, but there was alleged criminal vandalism and certainly the smashing of doors at the Shell? How does that help the cause of climate change? I respect what you're trying to do. Yours is a valid argument. You are, I would argue, you and your colleagues on the cusp of losing public sympathy. You have no right to close down a major city in this fashion for 3 days.
Well, thank you, first of all, for acknowledging that mass civil disobedience has been the foundation.
Measured.
Yes.
Can I finish?
Measured.
You know, in Parliament Square, I urge people to go to Parliament Square and go to the back where you see the statue of Gandhi, you see the statue of Millicent Fawcett, and you see the statue of Nelson Mandela. Mm. Three great giants.
Would you answer all of my
whom,
question?
All of whom have used mass civil disobedience.
Of course.
All of whom, during their lifetimes, were criticised and told to go and take the peaceful route out.
Okay.
And all of whom had, in the end, led movements. I am answering your question as to why we're breaking the law and why peaceful civil disobedience is being undertaken now.
But what about the human rights of the people that are trying to get to this hospital? There's a big children's hospital there. You know, ambulance having to take longer routes.
People are being caused disruption. I'm sorry. Please don't, you know, equate the human rights of people who are suffering from drought, who are suffering floods, who are, you know, actually dying. I'm sorry, please don't equate that.
You'll be aware.
With travel inconvenience.
You'll be aware. Farhana, you'll be aware. Parliament is in recess. Parliament. So the people, the lawmakers and decision makers aren't even here. You'll be aware...
Don't worry, they're listening.
The United
it's not like Theresa May hasn't got access to her Twitter account and
the
is
The United
not in
Kingdom
touch.
Is responsible for less than 1% of global emissions. The United Kingdom has gone further than any other country in the Western world in tackling, quite rightly this, a 30% drop since 1990. Why yes. are you not protesting in Russia, in China, in Brazil?
Where can I answer you are, that? So yes, if where you protest, I'm not in Russia and no. China. If people protest there, they are killed and imprisoned, Nick. So let's get real.
Well,
if you
not,
protest in India, right. you protest in China, if you protest
so you only
in,
protest where it's easy.
In protest in Saudi Arabia.
Ah, so you only
no,
protest where
those,
it's easy.
The citizens of those countries
I've
are under
it.
Immense pressure. Please I allow
see.
Me to finish and not interrupt every time I'm speaking. I'm doing the courtesy of listening to your point, so please don't keep repeatedly interrupting. Those people absolutely are fighting back. People from the least developing countries, the small island states that I've been representing, are fighting back.
But
one defender a week is dying in these
but
countries.
The government here
has
if listened.
You are saying...
But the government here has listened.
People, you know, Russia is hardly a state in which you can
well,
take this kind of pressure.
So
let me just address the question about the UK being a leading country. Yes, the UK has taken leadership, but the Climate Change Committee, which was set up under the Climate Change Act, Nick, has itself reported that we're not on track to, you know, to reduce our emission in line with our own carbon budgets. That's the reality. That's why people are frustrated that the goals that we set ourselves in this country are not going to be complied
but
with.
At this point, now, are you going about it the right way? Say, Farhana, for example, a member of your family was sick and they needed to get to that hospital in the centre of London, and the ambulances are having to use a longer route to do that because of what's happening. Do you think that's right?
I think that if you look at what the protests are doing, they're taking as much careful, you know, consideration as possible. So I'm afraid that traffic disruption is a normal part of Londoners' life, and we're doing everything possible, those people who are on the ground, to protect well-being and safety.
And the tubes.
And the tubes, Farhana, because they're saying that the protesters are saying that today they are going to take over some of the tube stations. And we have a statement from Sadiq Khan, and it says, it is absolutely crucial to get more people using public transport, and millions of Londoners depend on the underground network to get about their daily lives in our city. Do you think that's appropriate? Because the whole point is to get people onto public transport to reduce the traffic. What it seems to me, and just, you know, from watching and seeing, there's condensed big areas of traffic now sitting doing nothing, pushing pollutants into the air, and people can't, if they are going to block tubes, can't get to the tubes. Is that not defeating the purpose?
So I think that there has been a reduction in traffic, obviously, due to
Correct.
Some of the actions that we've taken. But in terms of your question about the tubes, we apologise. XR, who's organising some of these actions, apologises for all disruption. But to be honest, let me just be clear. There is no way in which I would have been invited to this show had it not be for causing disruption. For months and months, and in fact, I would argue for two decades, the does media it, has colluded. Can I just finish?
No.
The media has colluded in putting climate deniers and having a debate.
Does that justify criminal damage?
I'm saying we're at the
does
point where actually...
Damage?
We're at the point where doing
it's
mass
yes
civil
no.
disobedience. We're
does
doing mass peaceful
criminal
civil
damage?
Disobedience. We're doing mass peaceful disobedience.
To finish
those
here,
people who are doing that...
We're running out of time here quite rapidly. To finish, if this doesn't work and people don't listen to this, what is next?
What's the next step?
I think people should join in. They should start coming to the bridges. Come to Waterloo Bridge. It's a beautiful sight. You know, as a Londoner, it's the first time I've seen this bridge traffic-free and heard birds. The most amazing views, not clogged with traffic, by the way. Come to Parliament Square, hear what people are doing, hear why they're doing it, and join in. And understand that the UK is one of the most food-vulnerable countries in the world, and that we have been stockpiling for Brexit when we should be listening to the forecasters telling us that long-term food is at stake.
Thank you. Nick, will you be joining on the bridge
protest? No. Measured and respectful protest. That's what's required. Measured and respectful.
Thank you both
for coming.
Thank
you very much, both of you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
It's nice that we can disagree, but still respect each other.
Sure, absolutely.
Thank you.
We're all friends.